Today, I'm going to show you step by step exactly how to create and customize your QuickBooks Online invoices quickly with templates. Then we'll streamline your payments and set up automated reminders so you get paid on time every time. By the way, I'm David and I'm not an AI, and thanks to Intuit for sponsoring this video. Let's go.
So the fastest way to create an invoice is to click the new button and then go to invoice. From here, you just fill out all the fields and you're good to go. Just kidding, we're gonna walk through them step by step. First, make sure your company information is up to date. And if you wanna hide your address, contact info, or your logo, stay tuned because I'll cover that later in the video. Just be aware that if you click the X on this logo, it removes it from your entire account, not just the invoice. I'll show you a different method later. For now, let's add a customer. Obviously, this is who you're issuing the invoice to. When you click Add New, you can fill in as much information about the customer as you want. The only thing that's required is the customer display name, but I'll fill in the email too. Now make sure you scroll down so you can see all the other fields that you can set up. And when you're done, click the Save button. The email and address you filled in will show up here. Then you can set the terms of the invoice. If you're new to all this, remember net 30 means the invoice is due 30 days after it's issued. Now let's move on to the products and services. Click inside the cell under Product Service to add your first line item. QuickBooks Online keeps track of your products, so when you select an existing product, its description, quantity, and rate automatically show up. But you can also add a new product by clicking on the cell and then clicking Add New. Just like with customers, there's a lot of information you can fill in. Fill in the name, but then pay attention to item type. If this is a service, so there's no exchange of physical goods, then leave it as service. Otherwise, you want to change it to inventory item or non-inventory item. Use inventory item if you want to track inventory in QuickBooks. Otherwise, use non-inventory item. Now, I don't want to get your hopes up. You can add a product image, but it won't show up on the invoice. Description and price are pretty useful to fill in, so they show up on invoices by default. And then check out income account. You usually shouldn't mix up services and product revenue, so make sure you choose the correct account. When you're done, click Save and Close to add this one to the invoice. Once you've added your line items, you can modify the quantities and the rates, and those are just saved for this invoice. Before we move on, save your progress by clicking the Save button in the bottom right. Down in the footer of the invoice, there are a lot of different options, but the most important is getting paid. And if you want to accept digital payments, click the Activate Payments button if you haven't already. Follow the steps on this page to verify your business so you can accept online payments. When you come back to the invoice, you should see this. If the right sidebar isn't open, make sure you click the Manage button in the top right. Then you can change what payment method you accept. Now let's breeze through the rest of these options in the footer. Include custom payment options if you want your customer to pay in a different way. You can include a thank you note or other note to your customer, and this memo on statement is like a private note to yourself. There's a section for attachments at the bottom too. On the right-hand side, you can set up sales tax. That's beyond the scope of this video, but you can charge sales tax by line item, and QuickBooks will help you pay the right amount to the right tax authority at the right time. So far, we've been looking at a digital version of this invoice, but here's what it looks like to your customer. It starts with a payment page, and then they can click View Invoice to see the invoice. And here's the PDF copy. You can also send this out as a paper invoice if you'd like. So let's talk customization. Click the Manage button once more. Then guess what card you're going to click on? Customization. From here, you can show or hide just about anything in the invoice header or its line items. For example, you can turn on a shipping address, you can turn off the invoice number, invoice date, terms, and so on. You can also show or hide any columns within the line items table. For example, you can clean things up significantly by removing description, quantity, and rate. Now here's something that trips people up. All of these customizations only apply to the modern template. What's the modern template? Well, scroll down and expand the design card. We are right now customizing based on the modern template. If we choose standard instead, it seems like we have less options. Those color choices went away, and if we go back to customization, we don't have as many choices. But that's because the customization appears on another page. So if you want to customize even further, click this Add Edit link next to Other Templates. But make sure you save first with the Save button. Now let's go back to Add or Edit. To create a new template for your invoice, click on New Style, then Invoice. It's best practice to name your template first, so don't forget to do that using this text box. Now we'll go through the invoice design, invoice content, and invoice email design step by step. On the invoice design, you can start with a template. Each of these has pros and cons. It really just depends on your style. Some of you might find some of these cluttered, and others not so cluttered. I personally prefer less fluff, so I'm sticking with the original. Then you can choose to show or hide your logo. It will usually show up in the top right, but you can choose the placement and the size. You can change the color, but if you want a printer-friendly format, stick with black. Although it shows up as a gray bar here, when you go to print it, it'll be gone. Finally, you can choose the font and change up the margins if you want. Next up is invoice content, and there's a lot here. Let's start with the header. Now, you remember earlier when I told you you didn't have to show your company info? This is what I was talking about. You can uncheck any of these pieces of info about your business. To hide your address, click the Add Address field first and then click the checkbox. Then onto the form itself. You can choose to call this something other than an invoice, so let's call this one a Velociraptor. Form numbers means that the customer sees the invoice number, and you can select Use Custom Transaction Numbers if you want to control the invoice number. Finally, you can show or hide many of the same settings as on the modern template. I know you're dying to see this Velociraptor in action. That's it for the header. Let's click on the line items next. First up, you can choose to show existing payments and balance forward or not. And you have way more control over the line items. Not only can you show or hide the columns, but you can also combine columns like description, quantity, and rate. You can move columns around by clicking and dragging on the grip handles, and you can edit the column headers and their widths. Let's just move the date back to the start and call product item. Let's check out some of the more advanced options by clicking Show More Activity Options. Group Activity allows you to group items by date or by product type. Collapse Activity Rows allows you to combine rows that have the same product just on different dates. Show Progress on Line Items is for partial invoicing, an advanced feature which allows just partial payments. And Show Markup on Billable Expenses is for when you have expenses that you want to bill to a customer. With this, you can show your customer the markup that they're paying. Now let's finish up with the footer. You can choose to show discounts, deposits, or even estimate summaries for this customer. And if you have common instructions or notes for customers, you can use these two text boxes. For example, for common payment instructions or even a link to a survey. Finally, let's check out the email design. When you send an invoice, this is the email that the customer sees. There's not a ton of customization available, but you can summarize the invoice by clicking Summarize Details. Really, this just cuts out all the invoice details and leaves you with the payment amount. And you can attach a PDF version of the invoice if you want. You can also change the subject and the message that comes across with that email. The last email you can customize is the reminder email. This is sent automatically at a cadence of your choosing. I'll show you how to set this up after we send our invoice. Let's click Done to go back. To go back to an in-progress invoice, go to Sales on the left sidebar and then click Invoices. Scroll down and find the invoice, then click View/Edit. To use the template you just created, click on the design card and then select that template. Now to preview the invoice before you send it, click on the Print or Download button, then click Print. Double check this PDF version before you send it out. Assuming you're satisfied, the last step is to send the invoice. You may want to schedule this for later, but unfortunately there's no option to do so. Even if you click the scheduling card and then switch on Send Later, this just applies a tag you can search for later. It doesn't actually schedule it for a later date. With everything in place, click the Review and Send button. Now you see your email template in action, and Intuit Assist has even given you a better subject line. You can make any changes you want to this email without affecting the template, and even decide to text your customer for payment. When you're ready, click the big green button to get paid. Wasn't that just more fun than humans ought to have? To finish up, there are three more features which will get you paid faster. You'll see the first one when you create a new invoice. First, instead of writing line items by hand, open the Intuit Assist icon on the left sidebar. You can automatically create an invoice using a PDF invoice, images, or even text. Here's some rough notes on an order from the Kevin Cookie Company. Looks like they're doing some competitive research on cookies. With all the order details present, click Autofill. After about 15 seconds, the customer's filled in, as well as the line items. Feature number two are those automated reminders. You can access them from any page on the QuickBooks dashboard by going to the Settings icon in the top right and then clicking Account and Settings. From here, click on Sales, then scroll down until you see Reminders and click on it. Here you can turn on automatic invoice reminders. You'll get up to three automatic reminders. For each reminder, you can choose when it's sent, as well as a specific message. Use this to your advantage because the squeaky mouse gets the cheese. Finally, if these automated reminders don't work, you've got another line of defense, and that's an AI-assisted invoice reminder. You can find them on the business feed. Kevin hasn't paid this invoice yet, so let's review what our options are. The AI takes all this history about this customer and designs a message with the right nudge to pay. If you like, you can choose a different tone, starting from friendly or even humorous, all the way to stern. Use this when you've got writer's block and you need to get some money in.
Now you've unlocked the secret to effortless invoices, almost perfect templates, and faster payments. Thanks so much for watching. Drop a comment on what you want me to dive into next, and I'll see you in the next video.